Hallelujah. The King of the Kings has risen. And is the reason why we are celebrating the King of the Kings has risen. And he is the reason why we are singing. He has risen from the dead. Lift up your hands. Yes, he is Lord. Please give me the background of it. Yes, he is Lord, he is Lord. Every knee we bow. Every knee shall bow. Yes. Every tongue shall confess. Yabra no shake it. Yes. That my Jesus Christ is Lord over every situation. Yes! Yes! I want you to hear this. Every knee we bow. I want you to bow your knee before him. Bow your knee before Jesus Christ. Because when you bow your knee before him, then every tongue that rises against you begin to confess that your Jesus has risen. Death, sickness, infirmity, arthritis, cancer, HIV, diabetic, high blood pressure, blindness, deafness, poverty, delay, begin to confess that your Lord Jesus Christ has risen. And the Bible say, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. The power of resurrection. Disgrace, death, and shame in my life. That's why I say, oh God, you are alive. You are alive. Because you are alive, every situation in my life is living. And I know, I am living for you. Oh, le bragosh ito pragadaleta Caesar. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Libro dosh katiri alaba. Yes! Galaba. Rise upon your feet, begin to celebrate Jesus. Begin to celebrate the King of the Kings.
I can face tomorrow.
I can face every sickness. I can face every fears. I can face every challenge. Le bradobo shetekete. Yes. I like you to say, this, it is not my grave. Say it. It's not my grave. Say it louder. HIV. It's not my grave. Yo, poverty is, say it louder. I can't hear you. Say it louder. It is not my grave. Failure. Disappointment is not my grave. Come on, somebody take microphone for me. Failure is not my grave. Yes. You don't understand what I'm saying. Delay is not my grave.
It's not my grave.
You know, they thought they buried Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Yay! The enemy said, yay! We should not have crucified him. Say crucifixion.
Crucifixion
is not my grave.
It's not my grave.
Crucifixion.
Crucifixion
is my resurrection.
It's my resurrection.
Frustration is not my destruction.
It is not my destruction.
Frustration of Satan.
Of Satan.
Of devil.
Of devil.
Of enemy.
Of enemy.
Is not.
Is not.
My destruction.
Destruction.
Yes.
You don't understand what I'm saying.
Condemnation
is not.
It's not
my grave.
My grave.
They are disappointed.
Oh yes,
disappointed.
They were disappointed.
Oh yes, disappointed.
They went.
Yes,
to the grave to see Jesus. Are you still there? But
it's risen.
Oh, yes. Jesus said to them,
yes.
It's not my grave.
Hey,
it's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave. It's not my grave.
Not my grave.
Not my grave.
Not my grave.
Not my grave,
not my grave.
They must wake up, not my grave. Come on,
not my grave.
Say it,
not my grave,
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 not my grave.
Listen to me.
Yes,
the enemy has been waiting for when they will say, and display your obituary.
Hey,
not my grave.
They were waiting to hear that HIV has killed her.
Not me.
Say not me.
It
is not my grave.
It is not my grave.
They are waiting to read. And they've been looking at Facebook every day. When are we going to see our obituary? Because the doctor says he has cancer. And the doctor says he has diabetes. I don't think she will live for the next week.
Hey.
I don't think she will live next year.
Yes. Not me.
Say it is not me.
It is not me.
Because it is not my grave.
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 I dodge it.
I dodge it.
I escape it.
I escape it.
It is not my grave.
It is not my grave.
It is their grave.
It is their grave.
It is their grave.
It is their grave.
It is my enemy grave.
It is the enemy's grave.
You know, when they saw you this morning,
yes.
When they saw you this morning, they are arguing with you themselves.
Yes.
Is she the one?
Hey.
We plan accident.
Yes.
But this is me.
Yes.
The accident is not my grave.
It's not my grave.
Eh?
Yes.
Hey.
Please laugh at them. Just laugh. Just laugh at them. It's not my grave. 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 It's not my grave.
Yakaba sata yagaba.
Yes. Yes.
The poison they gave you yesterday night, through the dream, they shot an arrow.
It's not my grave.
Through the dream,
it's not my grave.
Hoping that by this morning, they will come and look at your bed.
Is she still
alive? Caro, they say, is she still alive?
I'm still alive.
This girl has refused to die.
My grave.
Why? It's not my grave. 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 They said, upon everything we are doing for her, upon every attack, she's still living. Hey! Hey!
Not my grave.
Hey! It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's your grave.
It's your grave.
It's their grave.
It's their grave.
You know why?
Yes.
Because I am glowing.
Yes.
Yes.
I am moving.
Yes.
I am growing.
Yes. Oh yes.
I am moving. They sent you a threatening message, threatening letter, threatening SMS. In fact, when they can't get hold of you, they sent you a threatening SMS. Come on. Tell them now.
Yes.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
Why? It is resurrection day.
It is resurrection.
It is resurrection anointing.
Yes.
It's what? Resurrection anointing.
Resurrection.
Anointing.
Yes.
Fall. The resurrection anointing is falling on somebody right now. Come on, receive it.
Yes, yes, yes. Take it.
Resurrection anointing. Resurrection anointing is coming upon someone here this morning.
Yes.
Come on, somebody's catching it now. Resurrection anointing. Stretch out your hands to Jesus Christ right now. And anyone that has been assigned for death, the resurrection anointing
is coming upon you now to resurrect you. Listen, as you receive this resurrection anointing, every spirit of death is going back right now to the sender. I'm going to release the resurrection anointing upon you now, and every death threat, every death threat is going back.
Yes.
To descender,
oh, yes.
Back to descender. Receive the resurrection anointing.
Yes, 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 receive.
Receive the resurrection anointing. Receive resurrection anointing. Receive resurrection anointing.
Yes, 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 yes.
Receive resurrection anointing.
Yes, 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 yes.
Receive resurrection anointing. Receive resurrection anointing.
Maka yakaba satanaba.
Now, there is a resurrection anointing in your hand now.
Yes, 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 yes.
Send it back, every death,
every spirit of death,
to the sender.
Back to sender.
Back to the sender. Say back to the sender.
Back to the sender.
Every spirit of death.
Every spirit of death.
Back to the sender.
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 Every spirit of death.
Every spirit of death.
Every arrow of death.
Every arrow of death.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to
sender. Back to sender. Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender. Back to sender.
Back to sender.
Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back to sender. Back
to sender. The last one. Everyone that has betrayed you. You know what happened to Judas Iscariot? He planned and executed Jesus' death. But Jesus arose. But he went to the grave. Is that not back to sender?
Yes.
Back to sender.
Is that not back to sender?
Oh, yes.
Back to sender.
Within 24 hours.
La Rocha Kata Yabala.
Within 24 hours.
Yes.
Within 24 hours.
Yes.
Every arrow of death.
Every
in your life.
Yes.
Bad to sender.
Yes, 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 yes.
Bad to sender.
Yes. Bad to sender.
Bad to sender. Every arrow of death. Bad to sender.
Yes.
Repo sata yika darabas.
Back to sender.
Back to sender.
La blazo para da 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 da
da.
You are a champion.
Yes.
You are victorious.
Amen. Yes.
You are victorious.
Amen.
You are victorious.
Amen.
You are victorious.
Amen.
I am victorious.
I am victorious.
Come on, give the Lord a clap of
praise. Hallelujah.
Be seated. Even if we close the service now, we have done justice. But I want to quickly show you a mystery. I want you to go home with assurance that you can argue your case that it is not my grave. It's not my grave. Even when you wake up tonight with every nightmare, terrible nightmare, this gonna help you. This message gonna help you. Anytime you wake up from every threatening death, blah blah blah, blah, this message gonna help you. Say it to yourself, ha 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 ha, it's not my grief. This gonna be in your tongue for the rest of your life. When sickness come, say to the sickness, it's not my grief. Because behind every spiritual attack, the ultimate aim of every spiritual attack or physical attack is to kill you and to destroy you. Because for the devil come not to what? Not only to steal, but to kill and to destroy. Every satanic attack in our life is not for him to jubilate or to celebrate. It's to bring himself to the grave. You begin to wake up from today with this understanding that no, I am more than a conqueror. I am more than a conqueror. It is not my grave. It is not my grave. I am more than conquerors through Christ who strengthened me. I am more than conquerors to Christ, my Lord.
I am more than a conqueror to Christ, my Lord.
Yes. What you will be till Jesus come and take me and you in the name of Jesus. Every threatening spirit in your life, every threatening arrow of death in your life, as I'm speaking the word of the Lord now, the word of the Lord penetrate your body and your spirit and your situation and your circumstances and heal you and deliver you in the name of Jesus. Be seated. It's not my grave. Jesus went to the grave and subdued the grave for me, for you. I want to show you a mystery of the power of resurrection that give you victory over spirit of death. I see people dying, walking but dying, talking but dying, eating but dying. I see people sitting hearing me now, but they are dying. Affliction is killing people. Disappointment is killing people. Delay, anxiety, fear, spiritual attack, humiliation of the people. People are humiliating you and is killing you. Yes. But is that the plan of God for me? Is that the plan of God for you? Why am I dying? People are dying. Circumstances are dying, making people to die. One situation want to turn people to their grave, early grave, loneliness. I know my sisters, my brothers, hearing me now, dying of loneliness. But I'd like you to wake up this morning and say, no more, it's not my grave. I am speaking to myself. I'm speaking to you. I'm speaking to the world. It's not my grave. I tell you, people of God, if I hear any accident or turbulent on the ear, I always say to it in my spirit that turbulent is not my grave. People can die of bomb attack, can die in Malaysia aircraft. If I was in Malaysia aircraft, I'm sure all those people would have been saved. Because I said to it, from long time, it's not my grief. Accident can never be my grief. Then the resurrection of Jesus is in vain. Say, it's not my grief. Say, this situation, these circumstances in my life, it's not my grief. Why? I am enjoying the grace of the resurrection. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. It's not my grief. Hear me. The Bible said Jesus was buried in the sepulchre. I want to show you a very quick secret. What is sepulchre? Jesus was buried in a sepulchre. Let me give you a quick definition of sepulchre as I look at it in the dictionary. The dictionary says a sepulchre is basically a stone room with a stone coffin where your body lies. It didn't say where your body buried. The word sepulchre comes from the Latin sepulchrum. Sepulchrum, which means burial place. For obvious reasons. Burial place for obvious reason. So it's not a common burial ground. A sepulchre is not a common burial ground. Jesus was not buried in Abbot Cemetery. You know some of those cemeteries we have been to in South Africa. You know it. Jesus was not buried there. Jesus was buried in the sepulchre. That brings the question, why sepulchre and what is sepulchre? Hear this. The dictionary said the signification of a sepulchre is the internal sense of the word signifies life or evil. Sepulchre signifies life or evil. So, and in the opposite sense, death or hell. So the opposite of a sepulchre is what? Death or hell. That brings this interpretation that sepulchre is heaven, but graveyard is hell. I took my time to say, what is sepulchre? And I have seen that we have so many sepulchre of the saints. Saints are not dead. They are sleeping. Jesus was not the first person buried in sepulchre. I saw in 2 Kings chapter 21 verse 18 talking about Manasseh sepulchre. The Manasseh. 2 Kings 21 verse 18. And Manasseh slept with his father and was buried in the garden of his own house. In the garden of Uzzah. I saw sepulchre of Elisha. Studio, you can go now to scriptural display. We come back to the background. The grave is not for me. Sepulchre is a place for the saint. And I'm going to show you. Grave is not for me.
I can't die.
I'm not dying now. And when I die, I'm not going to the grave. I'm going to the sepulchre. Because me and Jesus, we are one. When he died, he already bought a place for me in the sepulchre. Oh. Say, grave is not for me. Say, grave is not for me. Say it. I am not dead. I am alive. Grace is not for me. Grave is not mine. Because I live in his grace. I will have died. That boy come here to sing. I will have died. You know the song? But Jesus have mercy on me. When he was singing, talking, what is this called, this song? Godwin. But his grace, you know it? Hallelujah. Grave is not for me. Therefore, what is the resurrection power? The resurrection power opens all my grave. Matthew 27, verse 52 say, and the grave were open, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose. And came out of the grave after his resurrection. And they went into the holy city and appeared unto many. And the grave were open at his resurrection. His resurrection opened up the grave. That's why I am saying it's not my grave. My Bible tells me in Matthew 27, 52, and the graves, how many graves? Many. And the graves. Read it. I want you now to personalize it. And my grave was open, and my bodies, and my body, that were, or that is sleeping, arose. Hey, yeah. The grave open. That's why they are looking for Jesus, the living, in the land of the dead. And Jesus said, Mary, it's not my grave. And the grave, my grave. What is that? My disgrace. My disgrace. Open up. As you are stepping out of this service this hour, every disgrace, open up. Cancel for you. Disappear for you. And they sold themselves to the city. You are showing up to the city with miracle. In the name of Jesus. Hear this. Evidence that it is not my grave. The book of Mark chapter 16 verse 1 say, and when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Salome had bought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him. Verse 2, And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto where? Sepulchre, at the rising of the sun. Verse 3. And they said among themselves, who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And they look, said they look, said they look. The Bible says, as they look unto Jesus, their faces were never ashamed. And they look, as you are looking unto the resurrection power today, something happened. When they look, say, I am looking. Say it louder. Say it louder. Unto Jesus, the author and finisher of my faith. So I know I am not in the grave. And they look. They saw the stone roll away, for it was very great. I don't know today what is the grave, very big in your life, the challenges in your situation, the circumstances that is very big, more than you, as you look unto Jesus today, the author and finisher of my faith. I want you to look unto him. Sons, daughters, pastors, I want you to look unto him and his power of resurrection and declare it. This situation is not going to be my grave. This delay is not going to be my grave. Every situation staring at me looks at me like I'm going to die with it. I refuse to look at my situation. I look at Jesus, he that was dead and arose. Le bragosh into bragadiso to bragalabalaba. In the place of your situation, in the place of your circumstances, I want to show you something today that will change your mind forever. John chapter 19, verse 41. John chapter 19, verse 41. I want you to look at this scripture and register it forever in your spirit. Let's read it together, because I'm going to show you a mystery in that revelation. Are you there? Let's sit together now. One, two, three. Now, when? The resurrection day of Jesus Christ. Yes, go on. Now, in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden. Please, underline, there was a garden. Until when the Lord showed me this yesterday, I didn't know that there is something in the place of my grief, in the place of my situation and circumstances. I didn't know there is something for me there, in the place of my challenges, in the place of my circumstances and situation right now. The scripture says now. It didn't say later. Way? Way? When I am lonely now. When I am waiting now. When I am frustrated now. When I am crying, where is my partner? Where is my healing? Where is my children? Where is my fruit of the womb? The scripture say, and now. It's not my grave. If it is not my grave, then what is it? It is my garden. Now in the place where he was crucified. Actually, this is the message I'm bringing to you from God. You might have never heard it before in preaching anywhere, but you are hearing it today for the first time. In the place of the grave, there is a place of grace. Now, in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden. I am asking God, why? I've never seen it. I've never had anybody preaching it to me that there was a garden. In the garden, a new sepulcher. There was what? There was a garden. And in the garden, a new sepulcher. Where was never man yet laid. And as I was meditating on it, God said to me, do you remember the ash that was tied down and was never used? Jesus went there and took the ash. It was never used. He said, loose him. Let him go. Now, same Jesus was placed in a garden, a new sepulchre that was never laid. The garden was there. The sepulchre was there. Does it make any minute? Is it making any minute to you? In the grave, there is a garden. If a corn cannot be buried, cannot yield. If a corn cannot be buried, if a man cannot be buried, he cannot rise. If a man cannot fail, he cannot rise. It's saying to me, even when I am being down, when I am being down, there is a rising of the garden. The garden is there that when I fail, I will be germinated. That when I fail, the garden is there because that's not my grave. It's my garden. Put a corn in a grave. Bury it. Go back to it. You see it. What? Yeah. They might put my spirit in the grave. They are putting me in the garden. They are what? Putting me in the garden. Back to the garden. Hello? Back to the garden. I was in the garden when Satan came to deceive me. It took me out. It took me out. But his mistake was to launch me in the grave. Because in the grave, he's taking me back to the garden. Say, it's not my grave. This situation, these circumstances, it's not my grave. I want to show you quickly, something happened somewhere. And that's what I want you to hang this story. 2 Kings chapter 13. If you are not excited about this one, then you are a suspect. 2 Kings chapter 13, verse 20. I want you to read it loud with meaning. Are you there? 1, 2, go! And Elisha died. And they bury him. Invaded the land at the coming of the year. Verse 21. He revived. He what? He revived and stood up upon his feet in the sepulcher of Elisha. Now it's not the sepulcher of Jesus, it's the sepulcher of Elisha. The sepulcher of Elisha. So when Elisha died, he was not in the grave. Elisha was in the garden. He is still living. When the enemy thought you are dead, I want you to know you are still living. And when they place the man, when they place your situation, that's where I'm going right now. When I place your situation, when I place your circumstances, when I place your HIV, when I place your arthritis, when I place your diabetes, when I place your cancer on the sepulcher, in the resurrection day, you jump up, you jump up, you jump up, and then you rise on your feet. Yes. Come and rise on your feet right now. Yes. Come and rise on your feet right now. It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
Say it.
It's not my grave.
Say it.
It's not my grave.
You didn't see what I saw. He was dead. He was what?
Dead.
He was what?
Dead.
But they placed him. Where? In the sepulcher. Every sepulcher represents the resurrection power. And the man that was dead, I don't know the situation called death. I don't know the bones in your body that's already dead. I don't know the hope and situation and part of your life that's already dead. Your womb, cancer has killed it. Your blood, arthritis, diabetes, high blood pressure has already penetrated so deep. HIV has penetrated so deep. I have good reason for you this morning. As you lay on the sepulcher, the man revived.
Amen.
And stood up upon his feet. You are standing upon your feet. I say you are standing upon your feet.
Amen.
I say you are standing upon your feet.
Amen.
I say you are standing upon your feet.
Amen.
I said I am standing upon my feet.
Amen.
I said I am standing upon my feet.
I am standing upon my feet.
Yes.
Yes.
Revive me, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That's the song I want you to go on with. Revive me, Lord. Revive me, Lord. And he was revived and stood upon his feet. Why? He was standing on holy ground. I am standing holy God. Hey! Yes! Yes, yes,
we are standing in His presence.
There was a garden. Do you know where you are standing? Your grave is not your death. You are standing in a garden. Isaiah 51 verse 3 says, "For the Lord shall comfort Zion. He will comfort all our waste places. He will make our wilderness like Eden. Your desert like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness shall be found. Dear thanksgiving and the voice of melody in your garden." That is why the Sekopa was in the garden. The garden was in the Sekopa. Your situation is in the Sekopa. Your desire like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness shall be found. Do you want to know again? What is your garden? Come on, say, "It is not my grave."
It is not my grave.
It is my garden.
It is my garden.
Isaiah 61 verse 11 say, "For as the earth bringeth forth a bud, and as the garden causeth the things that are sown in it to spring forth, so the Lord will cause you to praise and to spring forth before all the nations." It's not my grave. It is my grace. After this service, the nation will begin to celebrate you. Why? Jesus came from the grave, came from the Sekopa. He becomes national hero. He becomes international hero. I want to see you. I want to see that person. You are from Soweto. You are from Alexandria. You are from village where there was no map, but the resurrection power raise you up.
Yes.
Raise me up.
Oh, yes.
Raise me up.
Oh, yes.
Raise me up. Hey! Yes, that's what it means. Yeah!
He arose!
It's not my grave.
not my grave.
Say it after me now. Sickness.
Sickness
is not my grave.
It is not my grave.
Cancer.
Diabetes.
Barrenness.
Failure.
Insomnia.
Deafness.
Blindness.
It's not my grave.
It's not my grave.
Poverty.
It's not my grave.
Poverty.
It's not my grave.
Brokenness.
It's not my grave.
Mockery.
It's not my grave.
Betrayal.
It's not my grave.
Disappointment.
It's not my grave.
Sin.
It's not my grave.
Righteousness
of God.
Grace.
The righteousness of God. In the resurrection of Jesus.
In the resurrection.
Is my grace.
Therefore.
I am stepping out of my grave.
Out of my grave.
I am waking up.
Of my grave.
I want you to walk out of that grave right now.
Yes.
Come on, walk out.
Grave.
Because the grace of the resurrection is upon me.
Grace.
Come and put your hand on your head and put the other one on your stomach or your chest, wherever it is. If I am sent in the order of the resurrection power of Jesus Christ.
Oh, yes.
Likrabasonto bragadisa. Iso bragadi to
Caesar.
And when Jesus stepped into the tomb of the Lazarus, The grave swallowed Lazarus, but it was not his grave.
Yes.
It was his garden.
Oh, yes.
And Jesus said, Lazarus!
Yes, come on!
Lazarus!
Oh, yes!
Lazarus!
Yes!
And the stinking man arose.
Oh, yes.
The stone was rolled away. Now, it's your turn to receive the same resurrection power. Every judgment of Satan, every demonic deposit, every spirit of death living inside you, at the count of three, at the count of Jesus Christ, the King of Resurrection, at the count of Jesus Christ, because I am a representative of Jesus Christ this morning, whatever I say must answer to me as Lazarus answered to Jesus. I call forth every spirit of Lazarus, every spirit of death,
oh, yes,
every spirit of frustration, every ascension spirit, every poverty spirit inside of this body, every sicknesses, every unidentified sickness, every demonic attack that is in this body, hear the word of the Lord, hear the power of resurrection, hear the power of resurrection. Now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Now in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I command you. I command you. Your spirit of death. We are the power of resurrection. Out of that woman.
Oh yes.
Out. Yes. Yes, it's a command. It's a command. It's a command. No resistance. Your spirit of death. Your spirit of death. Your spirit of poverty. Out. 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 The grave to vomit you now. Your spirit of death, lose that woman, lose that man, lose that sister, lose that brother. Yes, something is happening now. The graves is shaking. The earthquake of the Lord is breaking. Every grave. Lose that man and let her go. Lose that woman and let her go. Yes. It's not your grave. Out of that grave now. Out of that grave now. Out of that grave now. In the name of Jesus. Be seated. All my first timer, stand on your feet. This is your first time of being of coming here. Come to the front. This is what we enjoy as family. This is what we enjoy as family. The Lord brought you here to open the grave. You might have been under the grave and the slave of the grave. But God brought you into the royal palace to raise you from the grave to the grace. So you are rising from the grave to your grace. I speak to you that your grave is over. Your grave is over. Your grave is over. I shut the gate and the keeper of your grave. I release life unto you. What a good day, resurrection day. And the Bible said, and Jesus breathed upon them after his resurrection. I breathe on you now the breath of life. The breath of life. The breath of life. As my God liveth, life is entering you now. Name of Jesus. Life. Yes. I speak life to you. Receive life. Life. Receive life. Receive life. Receive life. 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 Yes. Out of your grave. Life. The name of Jesus. Yes. Receive life. Catch it. Receive life. Life. Receive life. Catch it. Catch it. Life. Life. Life of the Holy Spirit. Receive life. Yes, 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 yes. Receive life. Let life enter. Now, 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 life, life, every spirit of death out, receive life in your spirit, you breathe on them, bring her here, life. Life in your bones, life in your marrow. Yes, you breathe on them. Shut it loose. Shut it loose. Loosen now. The name of Jesus. Loosen, looser, looser. Come on, life in you now in the name of Jesus. Set her loose now. Give me the water. Yes. Come on, life. Restore the power of the Lord Jesus. Restore the power of the Lord Jesus. Lives in you. Rest in you. Life. Go and be set. Congratulations. Something's happening. In the mighty name of Jesus. Life. sister. You will return with testimony. Life. Bring her here. Yes. We are standing on the holy ground. Life is returning to people. Receive life. Today is your day of salvation. Today is your day of deliverance. Today is your day of healing. The power of the Lord is upon you, penetrating every spiral of darkness. Welcome to a new life in the mighty name of Jesus. Transferring the power of the Lord unto you. I'm transferring the power of resurrection unto you. No more death. No more failure. New life. New beginning. In the name of Jesus. Daughter, it is done. I see you. I see life to set you up and right with no direction. I see there was no direction. You don't even know what next. What next? What to do? But from this hour, life entered you. No more confusion. No more confusion. Do you agree with me? You agree with me? Rise on your feet, daughter. Rise up, rise up. No more confusion.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
We thank God. You are welcome.